is so good to see you. How have you been since our last visit together? Do you feel much better these days after having been buried in my garden? Good, good. Well, my friend, I have a very special treat for you. Today, I am going to bury your brain. That's right. I heard. Say vacation, isn't that so? That's what I heard. So what's going to happen is I'm going to remove your brain, which of course was surgically altered so that it could be removed by any one of us for various experiments and treatments. And that is exactly what's going to happen here. I'm going to remove your precious brain and plant it in this planter. And then I'm going to add some different soil types, which will help to rejuvenate and heal your brain and your mind. And then we will do some additional treatments. I'll take a sample of your brain for further diagnosis. And a few other things. How does that sound to you, my friend? Good, good. Now, before we begin, are you in a relaxed and calm state? Good, good. So, why don't we lift up your scalp, set that aside, and take out your brain, okay? Wonderful, just remain where you are. You shouldn't feel a thing. Okay. Let's remove your scalp. There we go. Just set that aside for a moment. Don't worry, we'll put it right back on once we take out your brain, which we're going to do right now. me get a little grip here on your brain and lift out. There we go. I believe this is the first time. Wait a minute, what is this? You seem to have some kind of thread or string attached to your brain all the way into your skull and most likely to your spinal column. Well, we can address that in a moment. But I believe this is the first time that I've held your brain in my hands. Oh, look, you have a little dirt on your brain there. Okay. Well, you have such a beautiful brain. Look at all of the folds of the cerebral cortex and the medulla oblongata underneath and the pons and the left hemisphere and the right hemisphere, and it's so beautiful. Why, Margaret could just spend all day giving your brain all the TLC it needs. And just in case you forgot, I'm sure you recall the professor mentioning that little nano microchip was placed right inside the lynx to the medulla oblongata, which allows your brain to be removed from your body and still transmit to your spinal cord all of the, and transmit and receive all of the necessary information so that your body can continue to live without the brain inside of your skull. Now, of course, you won't feel any of this at all. Look at such a beautiful brain you have. I have been dying to get my hands on it. You have quite a lot of information stored in memories. You can tell by all of the folds of the cerebral cortex. Such a thing of beauty. It really is. Okay, my dearest friend, what do you say we get rid of whatever this string is for? We can just cut it and set you free of whatever this is, the purpose of this being tied to or tethered to. Does that sound good to you? Okay, just a moment, let me just set your, well, just set your brain aside for a moment. And let me get my surgical scissors. They make such a nice sound, don't they? Okay, let's give this a nice little cut. Set your brain in here just for a moment, but I need to add some soil. I see that string is still I'm out of your skull. Let me just get in there. There. I wonder what the purpose of this is and why it's tied to you. Well, I'm sure it's nothing. Okay, let's just tuck the rest of that string back inside your skull there. If you want, later you can just reach inside your skull and maybe give it a good yank, okay? If it doesn't come out, just set up an appointment and we'll have to do a surgical procedure to remove it. Okay, let me put your scalp back on. Mixture of various soils. You see? Nice. Familiar with that place? The one with Sheriff Hopper. L or 11. And of course, my favorite, the Demogorgon. Those your favorite resident of, oh, I forget the name of that place already. Oh well, so let's get this opened. Yeah. I just dump it in. Arkham. Lots of great soil. Very nutrient rich from so many various types of organisms. Let's get this open. Next we have soil from the sunken city of Rolea, where Kevin was once kept prisoner. You know, Cthulhu is his real name. Let's get this opened up. Margaret has only been there once. She met a nice gentleman by the name of Pyramid Head. Yes. He was very kind enough to let Margaret gather some soil. Just a few more, and it will be soon time to plant your brain. Let's just get the next bag of soil that I have. Some nice folks such as Dale Cooper and Laura Palmer, Leland Palmer and Mike and Bob and the Hand. Wonderful place. Not the same Bob that my beloved the professor has in a crate. Not least, soil from hell itself. One of my most favorite places to visit when I'm feeling very stressed out. Let's get this added. oil from hell. Of course, Satan was all too kind to let me take some of his precious soil. A better tool. Okay, let's just mix this all around. Get all that soil from hell and the Glastonbury Grove, Silent Hill. Dear friend, for Margaret to plant and bury your brain. Okay, this is a truly momentous occasion. Here we go. Starting to absorb the nutrients from the soil, and all the different soil types are going to help it heal, and who knows, depending upon how long you wish to. Some of that cerebral cortex outer layer. There we go. Let's work all of that soil, the soil from hell. Just get that into your brain. All of it. There we go. Just keep some on top there. And then we'll completely bury your brain at the end of this. Okay. Alright. Now, I have some special things in store for your brain. First, let's remove some of the soil, actually, because I'm going to give your brain a very special healing treatment. I have with me an aloe vera plant. One of the stalks and apply some fresh aloe all over the outer cerebral cortex layer of your brain. Just keep in mind that this is something you can do in the confines or comfort of your own room here at the sanitarium. Just come down to my garden. Grab an aloe vera stalk and then just remove your scalp and just rub aloe vera all over your brain. Makes a very nice sound, doesn't it, my friend? Inside. See? Just set this aside there. And there, you see all that aloe. Just rub that all over your brain. There we go. It's like slime, almost. Get all of that aloe. Make sure we cover all of your brain. There we go. And now for some more, we'll just squeeze open, rip open the aloe vera stalk. See, all that aloe right inside, you just squeeze it, there you go, you see, just squeeze it all out, get it all out. mix it with all that soil from hell and Pripyat. And get your brain nice. Soil mixture, okay? Just a little bit more for the aloe vera. There we go, just to tear it open. And then just, whoops. And just squeeze it all out, rub it all over. Responding nicely to this treatment. Okay, my friend. Now, let's say, yes, I have a few friends that are going to keep your brain company and also protected from any tiny little never-do-wellers. Just a moment. See them with their little teeth, little hairs, when insects fly into their little mouths. The mouth will slowly shut, trap the insect, and it will be slowly digested. Can we just stop to think about that for a moment and the marvel that is evolution? Isn't it fascinating to just think a carnivorous plant evolved? Of course, it's nothing quite like the human-eating plants that I have growing over there, but these will suffice for any little bugs that wish to feast on your brain while it's planted here and during its stay here in my garden. This little family volunteered to keep your brain company. Isn't that right? Okay. So, we are just going to keep it in its little container. We don't want to remove it just yet. It's still fairly young. We will bury it right in the front here. Let me get my... make some room here. If that's enough. One, I have one more family that's also volunteer. Let's make some room on that side. Okay. You can take a look at them. And they are going to be never-dwellers, mosquitoes and gnats and the like. Okay, let's get this little family planted. See, the little insects will fly in or crawl in, and again they will get trapped inside of the pitcher plant's little mouth, where slowly over time the insects will be digested slowly. Of course, again, these are nothing quite like the giant-sized pitcher plants that are capable of digesting people or other large living organisms. Some room. There we go. Oops. Okay. I think that should be good enough. Let's give it a little spritz. Margaret has a secret concoction. I can't tell you the ingredients because it's a secret recipe. definitely going to help your brain. Let's just give it the little spritz. Escapes me for the time being, where they use little pins and needles and place them at different points all throughout your body. I don't think it's called acupressure. I forget the name, but anyway, I'm going to do that to your brain, okay? With these special little needles. Back here. these little locations on your brain are actually little points. And don't worry, pay no mind to these little needles being rusty. All of these locations are points. Of your brain to help release a lot of the very pleasant feelings and chemicals, endorphins, etc. Another one right there. There we go. Let's see. Right down here in the back. There we go. And one last needle, where would you like it to be placed? Okay. Good. Right there. No, over. Right here. No. Was it here? Okay. Right there. Very deep into your brain. There we go. And let's just give it a nice little spritz again. Okay. And now for a little secret recipe of mine. Just pour a little bit of that. There we go. Okay, very good. And then I just want to get sample, a little brain sample. Just cut a little bit right here. That into my little jar. There we go. Wonderful. And that, my friend, is your brain planted. Such a nice vacation for however long you wish it to remain here, okay? And don't worry, I will keep an eye on it to see how it's doing, and perhaps it may even grow, evolve, maybe even grow something out of it from all those different soils. Now, to completely bury it, let's get some more soil from Relea. Just to completely bury your brain. is anything you wish to say, dear brain, now is the time to say it. There we go. I'll leave a little stick out, just like that. Okay, my friend. It was very good to see you again. Now it is time to take your brain back to the other parts of Margaret's garden, where all the other patients' brains are buried. Until next time, take care of yourself, and don't worry, Margaret will return to give you a nice personal little checkup and visit. Little brain, it's time for us to go and make some new friends.